So this is random, but on my drive to the gym, there's this train yard. That's why there's always train clips in my vids, because I hit a train pretty much every time I go to the gym. And I slightly get the urge to just hop on a train and see where I end up. And recently I came across this YouTuber called Vagrant Holiday, and he has a vlog where he does that. I don't know, you guys should go watch his videos. He has like 6 vlogs and they're really random. They're kind of like what you would do if you wanted to exercise your free will and be homeless. That's random, but if you guys are bored after this video, go watch his vids, they're really entertaining. Okay, so over the last year, I've kind of grown a vitamin obsession problem. I don't know, I be health maxing. That's brain rot. But a couple of weeks ago, Huge dropped a bunch of other vitamins, so I think this is a good time to show you the vitamins I take. First, I must show you guys the vitamins that I think are important and are worth buying. The rest of them, not so much. First is vitamin D, especially in the winter. I don't really go outside year round, but for those of you guys who are staying inside during the winter and not getting any sun, this is good to supplement. Next is an omega-3 fish oil. You know, this is good for just like general health, joint, all that shit. Huge has one, but I ran out of it, so I'm just using this. Obviously creatine, everyone knows that's good shit. Basically trend for natural people. I've seen a few health people on TikTok talk about like magnesium being really important. I don't take this till the end of the day because magnesium can calm your central nervous system and I want that shit going crazy when I go lift. Now the rest of these, not so important. I have a vitamin B complex, which is good for like energy and central nervous system. I sound like my mom. I remember when I was a kid, my mom would want to test out vitamins on us to see if she was getting the right ones for us. She'd be like, all right, hold it to your chest. I'm gonna push down on your arm, and then we're gonna try it without it. And whichever one is stronger tells me if it's a good vitamin. So that's how we picked vitamins as a kid. I have zinc. This is another form of vitamin B. I don't wanna try to pronounce that. Pantothenic acid. I saw some videos saying this is really good for your skin, and I got shitty skin. I take this multivitamin from Thorne. It has like an AM and a PM. If you have like a wide variety diet and you've got like your fruits and veggies in, you don't need a multivitamin, but my diet's like really plain and I eat the same things all the time, so I decide I might as well get a nice multivitamin. This one's really expensive, probably not worth that. But also, if you're gonna get a multivitamin, don't like cheap out and get the one a day or some garbage like that. I learned about this on Looks Maxing TikTok. I'm generally really pale. This is what's in carrots, beta carotene. It kind of gives you like a oranger, darker complexion. And then I have turmeric. I don't really know why I take this. I'll be honest. I just saw a bunch of other lifter people saying they take it. So don't be like me. You should always research supplements and have your own reason for buying them. Like, don't buy any shit like this just because I say so. And then I just take pre-workout. I don't really take really any workout supplements except pre-workout and creatine, and then the rest is just these vitamins. I'm not gonna say vitamins do everything, but I do think they make a difference in terms of like performance and health. And like, you know, if you're gonna be more healthy and mentally clear, you know, you're gonna be able to go harder in the gym. A lot of people like ashwagandha. I don't really fuck with it. I've tried it, and you know how people be like, you know, they exaggerate and be like, oh, it's gonna make you emotionless and turn you into Patrick Bateman, Ryan Gosling. Now, as much as that's an exaggeration, for me, there is some truth to that, because like little things like when I take this, it's really hard. It's harder for me to get really hyped for lifts or like get that adrenaline spike, things like that. So I don't fuck with this. Before you guys go and decide to buy any vitamins or invest in supplements, invest in food first. That's like 1,000 times more important. But yeah, that's my vitamin haul. I'm gonna just see you guys when we go hit squats tonight. Bye.
Very fucking holy. Very fucking rare.
Even in broad daylight, I have this dream. This fantasy.
I have some new lifting gear to show you guys. But first, for you guys to understand these knee sleeves, you have to understand some powerlifting knee sleeve lore. So basically, for the longest time, for years and years and decades, maybe even centuries, if you wanted to get a serious powerlifting knee sleeve, you would pretty much just get the SPD sleeves or something like the Stoics, which are what I have. And they were all pretty similar. There's a lot more on the market now, but they were all pretty similar because they have to fit within a certain spec to be legit in a powerlifting competition. But then a few years ago, Inzer comes along, which is a powerlifting brand, and they come out with a knee sleeve that's within those specs to be legit within a powerlifting competition. But it's just like levels above the rest of them in terms of how much support it gives you, how much bounce it's giving you out of the bottom of a squat. I remember when it came out, everyone thought they were gonna be banned just because they were that much better than pretty much everything else. Fast forward to today, most companies have their own version of the stiff sleeve. And according to my friend Wheeze, Sean, you guys probably know him from Instagram, they all come from the same manufacturer. Like, they're all selling the same sleeve, just kind of rebranded. And the reason I never got a pair is because I was never really taking squats seriously, and they're like twice the price of a normal knee sleeve. But recently I decided I'm gonna get back into squats. And so I was finally gonna buy a pair. And the day I was going to buy a pair, I was looking for an all black pair with no branding. And Sean on that day drops a YouTube video basically talking about how he's starting his own company selling the stiff sleeve, where it's literally just gonna be all black, no branding, and without the crazy markup in price that all the other companies are doing. I think he's selling them for like $70 or $80. And the reason I never got the other ones is because they're like $150 or some shit. I would love to say I'm giving you guys a first impressions today, but I'm not. I've used them before. But they are just like, the difference between these and a normal sleeve, it's actually kind of crazy. Like, this is, it's kind of wild. Now granted, I've had these for a couple years, so they're pretty fucking beat to shit. And the white is cool and all, but as a daily driver, it kind of fucking sucks because they get super nasty. So that's why I wanted to get an all black pair. And then another reason I want an all black pair is because a lot of powerlifting companies, they put like really ugly branding all over their stuff. Wait, what do you want? They're low-key kind of scary compared to the regular knee sleeve, just in terms of how aggressive they are. Like, they definitely be giving you some weight on the squat. They're fun. And I decided, what's a better way to test them than to go max out today? You guys know I have a pretty poverty squat. I'm gonna try to go for 5 plates today. Last session I hit 475, which is a PR. Still kind of a poverty squat. I'd say to get out of like poverty squat land, we need maybe like 6 plates. We'll get there. I wouldn't get these if you're just doing a normal leg day. I'd only get them if you're doing like real squats, like a powerlifting style squat, because the stiff sleeves are pretty fucking uncomfortable to wear around during a normal leg day. Like, when I be doing the stuff after squats, it kind of fucking sucks. But for squats, they're fucking sick. If you guys do want to get a pair, just go follow them on Instagram. I think he said he wants to restock them mid-January. And last time they sold out in like 20 minutes, so just be ready. There's no codes or anything like that. I'm not sponsored. He did just send them to me. But I would have bought them anyways.
Since we're going for something heavy, you already know, 2 scoops of Enraged and then a bit of this. A lot of you guys ask what it's like to take this, and it's kind of like,
but yeah. If you guys do want to try my favorite pre-workout, you guys already know, code Nick, linked below. Let's go try to hit a squat PR. Bye.
So for those of you who don't know how to get a powerlifting knee sleeve on, it's a little tougher with these, but the way you get it on is you fold it in half, and then you pull it on. I remember I was putting on my knee sleeves at my old gym, and this guy came up to me and he was like, "Oh my gosh, that's how you get them on?" And he told me he gave away his knee sleeves because he couldn't get them on. Like, he was just trying to pull them straight on. He could have just Googled it. I don't know what, people don't know how to do that, but I guess. If you're still struggling to get them on even after folding them, you can thread a strap through them, and that'll give you some like leverage to pull them on. It makes it a lot easier. Now with these, you want to go true to size. You don't want to size down. A lot of you guys probably know with regular powerlifting knee sleeves, if you size down, you get more bounce and support out of them, so it helps you lift more weight. Like with my other pair of sleeves, the white ones, my true to size is medium, but I have those in extra, extra smalls and I can still get them on and off. With these, don't do that. But yeah, nothing left but to go squat.
Yo, so we failed that shit. So I could make some excuses, like, I mean, obviously I don't be squatting, so I'm not really, I'd say the strength is there, but my technique and like ability to execute a good squat just isn't there due to lack of practice. Now a lot of people will be like, "Oh, these are the best exercises to get good at squats, or these are the best exercises to get good at bench." The best exercise to get good at a certain lift is to do that lift. And the ones that are gonna help it the most are things really close to that, like maybe pause squats. Also, on my deadlift session, which was 2 days ago, I was just stupid and I ended with a set of 405 for 20. At the end of the day, I just need to become a stronger lifter. Anyways, I'm gonna drop down to 405, maybe do like sets of five. I think going forward, I'll do squats every other leg day. When I do them every session, my body really starts taking a hit and my deadlift takes a really big L, and I don't know. I think I can handle every other session. I think lower volume with it works for me. But yeah, we're gonna do those sets. Bye. Thank you. Now, surprisingly, a lot of you guys do ask me for squat tips, even though I'm not the most talented squatter. But one tip I can give you guys is learning how to properly brace, and this goes with deadlifts also. Also, how to properly use your belt. So one thing I see is a lot of people, when they go to deadlift or squat, is when they take in a deep breath, they'll take it into their chest. They'll go, and their chest will get all big. I honestly just think this might just make your lift worse because you're making your waist a little smaller. But what you want to do is you want to pull your deep breath into your stomach, like you're trying to make your midsection big and like kind of think like you're trying to make yourself look fat. Not really, you're not pushing your gut out intentionally, but you are bringing that breath into your stomach. So I'm not perfect at it, but your upper body shouldn't be going before you go lift. It should just be into your stomach. Now this goes in hand with the belt because when you expand your stomach and core, you're pushing into the belt. And then once you have that deep breath, you flex everything down there. And that's what's gonna give you a rigid, solid base so you don't bend over and you can stay perfectly upright when you do your lifts. Well, not upright, but you'll stay straight. Some people will see me like bend forward a lot while I squat. They'll be like, whoa, be careful, bro. Be careful with your lower back. That's really natural, especially when you're doing a low bar squat. You have longer femurs. Just from the nature of your build, your hips are gonna go back more and you're gonna fold a lot more. You can't really compare that to someone with short femurs who's doing a high bar squat because they're gonna be super upright. But yeah, that's how you properly use your belt and that's how you properly brace. Belt's kind of useless if you don't know what you're doing with it. All right, that's a wrap for squats. Those sets are actually a PR. The most I've ever done with 405 is one set of three in a single workout. So maybe we did fail the five plates, but still a good session. And these are the sets that really matter because that's what's gonna make me stronger. Anyways, all I have left for this session is RDLs, quad extensions, and then leg curls. But yeah, I'm gonna do all that stuff. I'm low-key dead, but I will see you guys after. Bye. Hope you guys enjoyed that 2003 Ford Taurus cold start. Days like this kind of make me wish I had a defroster, but we'll be fine. Funny story about the knee sleeves. So earlier I said, make sure you guys go true to size. And when I got them, I watched Weez's video and he said, you guys should go true to size. And I'm someone who likes to learn on my own. I think I know what's best for me all the time. So I asked him to send me a size small, which is one size down for me. And the moment I got them on, I knew I fucked up. They were so tight. I remember looking at my leg and the bottom half was a different color from the top half. And when I finally finished lifting and it was time to get them off, no matter how much I like ripped on them and pulled on them, there was nothing I could do to get them off. So I went up to this random guy at the gym, like I've never talked to him before. And I asked him if he could help me rip them off because I was like low key panicking because I was losing feelings in my foot. Man, I wish I had this shit on video. And this guy is like a grown ass man, like a big, probably in his 30s dude. And for like probably 10 minutes on each leg, he was ripping. I was laying on the floor, like my back was on the floor and my foot was in there and he was ripping on the knee sleeve and he was pulling so hard that I was lifted up into the air and on the opposite end I was holding onto a machine pulling myself the opposite way. We ended up putting like soap down my leg so it would like lubricate it. When they finally slipped off and all the blood ran right back in my leg because they got stuck at like the biggest part of my calf. When he was ripping on them, it was like ripping all my leg hairs off. Moral of the story, don't be stupid like me. Learn from my mistakes. These are super fun to squat in though. I'd say the only downside is putting them in your gym bag because they hold this sort of solid blocky form. I low key do think it's time for us to finally go invest in a powerlifting coach. You know, we've come pretty far not running a program or having coaching, but if I really want to see my potential through, I feel like that's the way. You know, I've said that before, but lately I've been really contemplating it. I think it's a good idea. My problem is I just really enjoy training the way I do. I know it's not the most effective way to get as strong as possible. You know, I have a general idea of what I'm doing. Like I know how to sort of ramp my lifts up so I can hit PRs. But there is something in training a way you enjoy, even if it isn't the most perfect way, because that's what makes it fun. I don't know, we'll see. I'm gonna go home. The shake I talked about in the last video, I'm gonna show you guys how I make it and what I ended up on. Yeah, I'll see you guys at home. Peace. Shake time. I did get a new blender for Christmas, so that's why I got a different one. I think someone suggested I should add oats to the shake, so I started doing that. But for the shake, I'm doing 2 cups of Fairlife,